This video shows how to do ANOVA Gage R&R using the SPC for Excel software. ANOVA Gage R&R is one of our components of the measurement systems analysis. You start to do an ANOVA Gage R&R by setting up the design, and it's called a cross gauge R&R. That's the most common one used. And you simply select that, select OK, and then you get your gauge R&R setup. This sets up the template for you to enter the data. We have three operators we're going to do for this one. We're going to use 10 parts, three trials. We're just going to call this MSA for our title. And then you need to enter the number of decimal places in the measurements. This helps with the rounding that's used. And you then select OK. And you have your template. And you come back and fill in the template. You begin by entering the operators' names. We'll just call them A, B, and C since we have three. And then you're ready to enter the data. For example, operator 1. Trial 1 of part 1 goes here, trial 2 of part 1 goes here, etc. I already have the data over here, so I'm going to just go ahead and copy it over. Control V. Now if you run the analysis just here, you're going to get the gauge R&R results based on the variation in the parts used in the study. If you want to base it on a process standard deviation as well, you need to enter that process standard deviation. We're going to do that. We'll enter value 2. And if you want to compare it to specifications, you need to enter your specifications as well. So we're going to enter 3 and minus 3 as our specifications. So we have our data entered. We could enter the date and the gauge name and gauge number, etc., but we'll skip that for now. And then we're ready to begin the analysis. And so we select MSA from the SPC for Excel toolbar, and you have the option to analyze the cross gauge R&R either by analysis of variance or by the average range method of AIAG. We're going to use the ANOVA method, and we'll select OK, and it gives us the default settings. The sigma multiplier, the default is 6. The alpha to remove the interaction term, we've set that to 0.25. Both of those can be changed. And then there are a number of charts that you can use. We'll leave the option set to no charts for now, and we'll look at the charts here in a little while. Select OK, and you get your results generated. The first chart you see is the variance components charts. What it's done is it's taken the results and breaks it down by variance, which is the analysis of variance, by the standard deviation, if you entered by the standard deviation based on that variance, tolerances, if you entered the specifications, and then your process sigma, if you entered the process standard deviation. And you can see down here, this gives you the total gauge R&R. This is what you're looking for, and the analysis of variance says it's 7.76%. And so you can see the repeatability, reproducibility, and the part-to-part variation. So this gives you a quick picture of the results and shows that this test method's not too bad. You also get an ANOVA report method that comes out. And what you'll see up here in the top part of that is simply the gauge information that you entered. And then you'll begin with the analysis of variance table with the interaction. If it is significant, the sources, the part and operator, they'll have a p-value less than 0.05 and it'll be in red. And you can see the interaction term operator times part is 0.974 p-value, which means it's not significant and can be removed since the alpha to remove is 0.25. So we're going to go ahead now and remove it, and here's the ANOVA table with the interaction removed. And then you begin to develop your contribution based on the variance or the analysis of variance. And so here's the variance for each of the source of variation. Over here, the percent contribution to the total. And the total gauge R&R is 7.76%. The table also contains then the other percent contributions. Here's the one based on standard deviation using our multiplier. Here's the one based on tolerance. And here's the one based on process sigma. We also give you the number of distinct categories, which is equal to 4. So this shows how the analysis of variance is done using the SPC for Excel software. Let's take a look at some of the options that come with it. There are a number of options that come with this. We showed you the charts. We'll go back and take a look at that. So I'm going to select MSA again. It thinks we're going to analyze the results again, but that's okay. We'll select OK. You get a warning that there's already a gauge R&R in this workbook. You only want one gauge R&R per workbook. And then we could have our charts to include, and we could select charts. And some of the charts we have available are the X bar and R charts, both stacked and unstacked. You get run chart by part or by operator. You get the scatter plots, the error charts, whisker charts, XY plots, normalized histogram. These are all the ones that are in the AIAG manual. And you also get operator range charts or operator bias and consistency charts, which comes from Dr. Wheeler's work. And we're just going to select those. We'll select OK. And what you'll see then is you have the bias and consistency chart for the operators. So you have the operators here, A, B, and C, looking for if there's any bias. And here you have the range chart with operators A, B, and C, trying to see if there are any significant difference between the operators. Also, you have the ability to, of course, do the classical average and range method from the AIAG if you want. But this is the ANOVA Gage R&R using the SPC for Excel software. Hope you enjoyed the video. Thank you for taking the time to watch it.